Hi, I'm a full stack WiFi manager at NG Impact. In this video on the fundamentals of corporate decarbonization series, I'm going to explain what a current state assessment looks like and why it should be one of the first steps an organization takes on their decarbonization journey. A current state assessment evaluates materiality, organizational capabilities, and overlays that with stakeholder interviews and more to get valuable data that provide a holistic understanding of an organization's current state. This assessment helps establish baselines and benchmarks so the organization can craft a clear data-informed path forward. A few common action items for a current state assessment include the following. First, you want to perform initial inventories to assess which sites you'll be able to implement sustainability changes for. Secondly, you want to analyze your organization's current capabilities, overall strengths, and areas for investment. Also, you want to research industry trends and standards, as well as utilize publicly available data to establish peer benchmarking. You also want to evaluate the flexibility, resilience, and performance of the organization. And finally, you want to assess these findings to inform your targets and then align your emission goals with your corporate strategy. With the initial assessments in hand, organizations can develop science-aligned targets. But here's the key. You must perform a reconciliation exercise against existing corporate goals to ensure that your emissions targets align with your overall organizational efforts. When your existing efforts align seamlessly with your emissions targets, you can create complementary benchmarks and key performance indicators. This strengthens the established efforts and reinforces their importance. However, if there is a conflict between the emissions target and strategic business objectives, adjustments need to be made. In this case, you should prioritize the established science-based decarbonization goals. It's crucial to ensure that our efforts align with what the science tells us is necessary. Effective plans always start with the baseline. I hope this explanation helps you understand the importance of conducting a current state assessment early on in your decarbonization journey. For a deeper dive into the fundamentals of decarbonization, please explore our other videos in this series. Thank you for watching.